Okay. Nandito ko ngayon sa sample problem solving 2 ng discussion material natin na 1.1 overview of cash and cash equivalents. Yung sample problem na to is related dun sa discussion natin ng cash on hand. So, yung cash on hand na discussion na yun, continuation lang naman yun ng ating discussion material. So, proceed ako dito sa sample problem solving 2. Sabi niya dito, high-speed company discovered and disclosed the following transaction for the year ended December 31, 2019. Okay, meron tayong ditong 4 transactions daw na nag-transpired sa 2019 na dinisclose noong December 31. Okay. Tapos, tinatanong the required adjusting journal entries sa number 1, adjusting journal entries sa number 2, adjusting journal entries sa number 3, at saka sa number 4 and 5, adjusting journal entry sa number 4, depende kung yung amount immaterial or material. Unahin natin yung transaction 1. Sabi sa transaction 1, draw and recorded a check in the amount of 22,000 as payment to a supplier for goods purchased on account on December 2, 2019. The check remained undelivered at the end of the reporting period. Undelivered daw. So, i-analyze muna natin yung naging journal entry made. So, since nagbayad daw tayo, draw and recorded, so parang nagkaroon daw ng payment, so debit tayo ng accounts payable for 22,000. Then credit tayo ng cash for 22,000. Yan yung initial entry natin. Paano naman yung adjusting entry? So, yung adjusting entry natin dyan, simple lang. Just reestablish again, reverse lang yung naging initial entry natin. Debit tayo ng cash. 22,000. Tsaka credit tayo ng accounts payable. Reestablish lang. 22,000. Next. Requirement 2. Yung sa requirement 2, sabi niya, issued a check drawn in the amount of 14,000 to a servicing company. The check was delivered on November 28, the same day it was drawn. But the check bears a date on January 31, 2020. The intended post-dating was to secure sufficient fund in the bank. Nangyari dito, noong November 28, nag-issue tayo ng check for payment. Yun nga lang, yung check na yun, merong date. Yung date na yun, January 31, 2020. Ibig sabihin, may in-cash pa siya ng recipient sa January 31, 2020. Pero na-record na natin siya as payment as of November 28 pa lang. Tanong, as of December 31, 2019, may effect ba ng payment talaga? Wala. So, kailangan natin i-adjust. Yung initial entry natin, ganun pa rin, debit ng EP. For 14,000, then credit tayo ng cash for 14,000. E kaso, walang actual payment as of December 31. So, i-reverse lang natin yung entry, debit tayo ng cash for 14,000, then credit tayo ng accounts payable 14,000. Okay. Assume lang natin dito yung accounts payable kasi yun naman yung parang usual na liability na na-encounter natin. You can use other accounts for liability, depende na sa transactions. Dito sa example, we'll just use accounts payable. Okay, requirement 3. Dito naman sa transaction 3, hindi naman tayo dito nagbayad. Tayo naman yung naka-receive. Sabi niya dito, received a check as collection in the amount of 20,000 from an auditing company. The check was received on November 30. But the check bears a date January 31, 2020. Okay. Noong November 30 daw, naka-receive tayo ng check eh. We recorded it as a collection. Pero, yung nangyari, hindi pa talaga natin yan na pa-encash as of December 31. Kasi nga, sa January 31, 2020 pa natin siya ma-encash. So, as of December 31, no effect of collection dapat. So, yung ginawa natin, we debited cash muna, knowing na may collection daw tayo, when in fact wala, then we credited AR, accounts receivable, for 20,000. Yan yung naging initial entry natin for the collection. Eh, kaso nga lang, wala tayong actual collection dyan, so we have to reestablish the receivable account. Debit ka ng accounts receivable for 20,000, then credit ka cash. Kasi nga wala naman talaga tayong na-receive na cash. Okay. So sa number 4 naman, tinatanong, ano yung adjusting journal entry kapag yung amount si material. Okay. Ito yan. Yung sabi dyan, issued a check drawn in the amount of 5,000 to a small supplier of spare parts. However, the check became stale when the supplier failed to encash the check within the bank's encashment period. Okay. So, nakastate na na hindi daw na encash. So, tayo yung nagbayad dito. So, yung initial entry natin, debit tayo ng accounts payable, credit tayo ng cash. For how much? 5,000. 5,000. Yan. E kaso, yung ina-assume natin sa number 4, paano daw yung adjusting journal entry natin kung yung amount is immaterial? Ano yung magiging entry natin dito? We have to debit cash. Apply lang natin yung concept. And since immaterial, parang nalibre tayo dun sa liability natin, we have to credit it at the account other income. 5,000. 5,000. Bakit other income? Kasi nga, inassume natin na immaterial yung 5,000 naman. Okay. Next, number 5. The same pa rin, transaction 4, pero yung amount ngayon is material. So, the same lang naman yung magiging entry dito. Debit ng AP, credit ng cash, for 5,000. But this time, since yung amount involved is material, re-establish natin yung liability natin. Debit tayo ng cash, then credit tayo ng accounts payable. Let's assume again accounts payable. Okay, yan yung difference ng requirement 4 at requirement 5. Ngayon, magtatanong kayo, ano nga ba yung sinasabing materiality? What is materiality? Okay. How can we say that an amount is material? Well, depende na yan sa mga problem solving. Dapat sa mga problems, yung mga transactions, nakastate mo yung amount material or immaterial. Basically, yung assumptions natin, dapat yung amount material. Okay. Kasi yung materiality, ganito yung concept. maybe an amount to a small company is material, but immaterial to a big company. For example, 1,000. 1,000 is already a material amount for small businesses. But for large businesses, medyo immaterial yan. Pero when it comes to cash disbursement, cash payments, we should always assume na material yung transaction, material yung amount involved. Okay? So, ano yung assumption ulit? Kailangan assume material. Assume always material. Okay? I hope na-apply nyo yung concept on how to adjust transactions involving cash. Yan, yung undelivered checks, post-dated checks, at saka yung stale checks. Okay? Thank you.